Good morning, everyone. It's Miss Carol again, and I'm here to bring you another Bible story, or a parable, which is a story that Jesus told his followers, and it helped them learn about things in different ways. Parables are a wonderful storytelling mode, and it really helps, I think, especially younger readers and younger lovers of God and Jesus, to follow in his words, but do it in a way that is understandable to them. And that's why I love the parables so much. They're so much fun to read, and they always have a wonderful story, and especially the endings are always so great. Today, we're going to be talking about the shepherd and the lost sheep. And I brought my little friend Lamb Chop with me. I love Lamb Chop. He's a very special lamb. He was actually my granddaughter's sheep, and she loved whenever she came to visit, she would always cuddle up with this little lamb and take a nap. Or when she stayed over at our house, she would cuddle up with this lamb and go to sleep. So this is my little special lamb, and he's joining us in the story today. All right. Have you ever lost something and wondered where it was? Did your pet ever disappear and your whole family searched to bring it home safely? Have you ever lost a friend? If any of these have happened to you, you can imagine how the shepherd in the story felt. 100 sheep! If just a single one were lost, who would notice? Who counted sheep anyway? Well, the man did, right here in our story. He's called a shepherd. The man had a lot of sheep, 100 of them, and he counted them every single day. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. And he kept on counting. 20, 30, 40, 50, 60, 70, 80, 90, 100. It took a long time to count, a very long time, because the sheep didn't stay still. They were moving around. One day the man counted 10, 20, 30, 40, 50, 60, 70, 80, 90, 91, 92, 93, 94, 95, 96, 97, 98, 99. Then he stopped. There were only 99. He must have made a mistake. He had 100 sheep, not 99, so he counted all over again. Still, there were only 99. One of his sheep was missing. He was responsible for all the sheep, all 100 of them. Immediately, the man went to look for the lost sheep. He walked and walked, but he saw nothing. He kept walking. He looked to the left, nothing. He looked to the right, nothing again. He walked and he listened. Still, nothing. Then he heard it. A bleating sound. Bah! Bah! He ran towards the sound, and there she was, the lost sheep. He had found her. She was too tired to follow him home, so he lifted her up on his shoulders and he carried her. He was so happy to have all the sheep together. He invited everyone to celebrate. Some people said, "What's so wonderful? It's only one sheep. You had 99 others," the man said, and smiled. One sheep makes all the difference. Without her, something is missing, and now my flock is complete. Can you see this happy lamb? It's very, very happy. And so is the shepherd, because now he has his sheep back. Well, you know about shepherds, don't you? There's someone who take care of sheep. And you have parents, and they take care of them. But I wonder what kind of jobs shepherds do. Well, the best answer I found was they watch over the sheep to keep them safe from other animals like wolves or foxes or any other predator that might come and grab them. Wonder, do you think that God is a shepherd? And we're his lambs? I think maybe so. That's what this story has been all about. So, what kinds of things do you think shepherds do for their sheep? What do your mommy and daddy do? They protect you. Shepherds protect sheep from wild animals that may want to eat them. Oh, we wouldn't want that to happen, would we? No. Just like your parents don't want anything to happen to you. So when you're outside and playing, mommy and daddy keep an eye on you to make sure that you're okay. And if you ever want to go to a neighbor's house, what do you do? Do you tell your mom and dad where you're going? Mm-hmm. That way they know that if you have a problem, they know where to find you. So let's think about this story for a minute. What happens when a sheep gets lost and wanders off? What did the shepherd do? Did he just sit down and say, oh, well, the sheep will come back? What did he do? Do you remember? It has to do with counting. How many sheep did he have? 100. So the shepherd went and he counted all the sheep. And he got all the way up to 99. And he couldn't find his little sheep, his little lamb. And, you know, he got worried. And instead of sitting down and saying, oh, the little baby sheep will come back, it'll be fine. No, he went looking for his little sheep, just to make sure that it was okay. And what happened? He found his little sheep. And do you think the shepherd was happy? Or do you think he was angry with the sheep for getting lost? What would your mommy do, or your daddy? If I lost my child or my little sheep, I would look high and low to find my little sheep. And then when I found my little sheep, I would give it a great big hug, because I love my children and I love my animals. I have two cats, and if I can't find them, I go looking for them, and then I find them and I give them great big hugs. And that's what the shepherd did in this story, because he loved his sheep, all of them, all 100 of them, and he didn't want anything to hurt his sheep. So how can we help take care of God's sheep and our community? Think of our community. It could be your town or your city or your school or your neighborhood. What can you do to help take care of God's sheep? How about, can you help others if they don't have a place to sleep? There are shelters for people who don't have a place to sleep. Or maybe you have relatives that are visiting from out of town. What do you do with those relatives? Tell them to sleep in their car? Oh no, that wouldn't be good at all. You say, come to my house and you can sleep at our house. We've got lots of sofas and extra beds and cots, and you're welcome to stay with us. We also have shelters that we can provide to help keep people safe and warm. That's what I mean about sharing God's love. We have so much to share, whether it be a house or a warm meal or a blanket. We can always give people something if they're in need. We take care of them. That's what shepherds do. They take care of their sheep and their little lambs. So, this is what God wants us to do. He's saying, take care of others less fortunate than yourself. And it doesn't matter. It could be a friend at school and you notice that, oops, they forgot to bring their lunch today. What could you do as a friend? I think I know. I think we have some very good people in our audience today. I think you would know that you would share some of your meal with them. That's what usually happens. And that's what God and Jesus wants to see. He wants us to share and take care of one another. So let's listen to the memory verse that we have today. Rejoice with me, I have found my lost sheep. So if you ever find that you've lost your sheep or your favorite stuffed animal or your favorite toy, I bet if you asked God or prayed to Jesus and say, can you help me find things? I lost my favorite stuffed animal. I bet somebody in your family would help you look for it. I know we always do in our household. Somebody is always losing something, usually our car keys, which is not a good thing for adults. But anyway, God will find a way to help you find your lost sheep or maybe your lost car keys. Let's end our session in prayer today. Dear God, thank you for teaching us to care for one another the way you care for us. We rejoice that you are our good shepherd and help us to take care of your sheep too. Amen. That's the end of our story time or our parable time today. I enjoyed this week with you. I hope you learned something about Bible stories and how God and Jesus want us to treat others, not only people, but animals and the earth as well. We're here to be the shepherds, just like Jesus was a shepherd, and he took care of sheep and his disciples and his followers. I hope you do the same, and you keep on reading Bible stories and listening to the Word of God. It's been my pleasure to be your storyteller this week, and I wish you a happy, wonderful day. Thank you. Bye.